Hi children, welcome to the class. Did you remember what we learnt in the last class? Yes, about factors influencing chemical reaction. We saw how the nature of reactant and concentration influence the rate of a reaction, right? Today we will see the other factors and how it influences the rate of a chemical reaction. Let's make a start on. Experiment 3, surface area and rate of reaction. The materials required for this reaction are marble piece, powdered marble, dilute hydrochloric acid and test tubes. Let's start the experiment. Take two test tubes. Put a marble piece in one and powdered marble of equal mass in another one. Add equal quantity of dilute hydrochloric acid in both test tubes. Let's see how dilute HCl react with the marble piece and with marble powder. We can see that more carbon dioxide bubbles formed in the second test tube than the first one. The chemical equation for this reaction can be written as CaCO3 calcium carbonate plus 2HCl hydrochloric acid gives CaCl2 calcium chloride plus H2O water plus CO2 carbon dioxide. Now you saw that the rate of reaction is different in two test tubes. Let me ask you some question. Is there any difference in the concentration of acid in both reactions? What about the mass of marble? Are they equal or not? In this reaction, there is no change in the concentration of acid and the mass of the marble. The factor that influences the above reaction is the surface area of the marble. When solids are made into small pieces or powder, their surface area increases. As a result, the acid molecules undergoing effective collisions with the marble also increases. Hence, the rate of reaction increases. Did you get the reason? Let me explain once again. When solids are made into small pieces of powder, their surface area increases. As a result, the number of acid molecules undergoing effective collision with the marble increases. Thereby increases the rate of reaction. Okay, now let's move on to the next experiment, temperature and rate of reaction. The materials required for this reactions are sodium thiosulfate, dilute hydrochloric acid, water, boiling tube and spirit lamp. Take equal volume of dilute sodium thiosulfate solution in two test tubes. Heat one boiling tube for some time. Add dilute hydrochloric acid in equal amount in both the boiling tubes. Now what do you observe? In which of the boiling tube is the precipitate formed faster? What is the color of precipitate? The color change is due to the precipitation of sulfur in both boiling tubes. Now see the equation. Na2S2O3 sodium thiosulfate plus 2HCl hydrochloric acid gives 2NaCl sodium chloride plus H2O water plus SO2 sulfur dioxide plus S sulfur. From this experiment, you may understood that the factor that influences the above reaction is temperature. Let us know how this factor influences the reaction. To take part in a chemical reaction, molecules should attain a certain minimum kinetic energy. This energy is called threshold energy. Let me tell you once again, to take part in a chemical reaction, the molecules should attain a certain minimum kinetic energy. This energy is called threshold energy. So when reactant molecules are heated, the energy as well as the speed of molecules increases. That is, as temperature increases, the number of molecules with a threshold energy increases. As a result, the number of effective collisions increases, and thus the rate of reaction also increases. So in this experiment, the temperature influenced the above reaction by increasing the number of molecules with a threshold energy. As a result, the rate of reaction increases.